Hello and welcome to this demonstration in the course for Secure Systems Engineering. This demonstration is for format string vulnerabilities. So we've already looked at the theory for format string vulnerabilities, and there are some examples which were taken in the theory. So we will demonstrate these examples in this lecture. So the codes for this thing is available in the virtual box, which comes along with this particular course. So you can download the virtual box, look into this particular directory, NPTEL codes, module 6. In this directory, you have all the codes regarding the format string vulnerability. So let's open the first one, that is print2.c. Oops, sorry. Okay, so vim print2.c. And what you see here is a very small program where main starts here. There's a user string of 100 bytes, and this user string is set to 0 using the memset function, and there is a string copy over here. Now this string copy fills in user string with 40A00408. There are 6 percentage X's and then a percentage S. And finally, there's a printf user string. Note that the first argument to printf is a format specifier. There is a vulnerability in this program because the printf which is specified here, the format specifier is essentially this string present in user string. So the objective of this program is to demonstrate that we could manipulate the way printf works so that this message, this is a top secret message, gets displayed on the screen. So note that in anywhere in this program, the global variable S is not used. However, we see that when we compile this program and run it, we would obtain the global secret message. So let's do that. So to run it, run the program, we can do a make clean and then make. And the program we are interested in is print 2. So we'll run print 2. And what we see is some hexadecimal values that gets printed. And finally, we get this is a top secret message that gets displayed onto the screen. So what is happening over here is that there's something fishy going on in this format specifier present in user string, so that somehow this global variable or this global data gets printed on the screen. So to investigate what's actually happening, let's do so with GDB. So let's run the program in GDB. We specify a breakpoint over at line 16, and before we actually enter into the printf, we'll take a note of a few important things. First, the address of the global variable S can be determined as follows: p underscore s ampersand s, which has a value of 804A040. Now look at this string present over here, and what has been encoded in this string is exactly the same value of the S. So this is represented in little Indian notation, therefore you read it from the starting from here. So it is 0804A040, which exactly is the address of S. The next thing we would look at is the disassembly of main. And we see that the call to printf here, in this case the printf at PLT, is in this particular memory location, and the return is present at location 0804851B. So we can note this down. We can have a notepad here and note down the address as 0804851B as the return address, return from address from printf. Okay. The next thing we actually look at is the address of user underscore string. So that is p slash x ampersand user underscore string. It's FFFFCF48. FFFCF48, which is the address of user underscore string. Okay, so let's say single step and see what exactly is happening. So we single step with the SI, and so we are still executing. We are going into printf plt, going into the loader, and we have now entered into printf. Now at this point, we shall look at what is present on the stack. So we do so as follows: x slash 19x dollar ESP, and the first thing we would identify on the stack is the location where the return address is stored. So note that the return address is present in 084851B, which is essentially present over here. One word before this return address is where the arguments to printf is present. So FFFFCF48 is essentially the argument for printf, which essentially is the address of user string. Now when printf executes, what happens is that it would read its first argument, that is the address of user string. It would go to that particular location FFCF48 and start to print the contents of the string. So for example, it would go to the contents of user string, print the first word, which is 0804A040, and then it would see that the next requirement is a percentage x. So when there's a percentage x, it would mean that it would take and print the next argument which is present on the stack. Note that here we have not specified any arguments to printf besides user string, right? And therefore the printf code does not know this, and therefore it assumes that 4 bytes prior to this first argument is where the second argument is present, and therefore the display would be 0000000. Similarly, at the second percentage x, printf will assume that it has to read the third argument from the stack, and therefore 64 gets printed. Similarly, the fourth percentage x would print this F7E978FB. As printf is parsing user string, it would first print the contents of this location, which is 0804A040, and it would continue to parse the string and see that there is a percentage x. So when there's a percentage x, it expects that you want to print the second argument to printf, and therefore it looks to the stack for the second argument. Now since the first argument is specified at this location FFFFCF48, the second argument would be 4 locations ahead of this, that is at FFFFCF34, and printf would pick up this value, which is all zeros, and display it on the screen. Similarly, at the occurrence of the second percentage x, printf will assume that you want to print the third argument, and therefore it would pick up this from the stack, 0x00000 and 64, and similarly the fourth, fifth and fifth arguments would be F7E978FP and FFFFCF6E and FFFFD06C. The final thing is at the sixth argument, you have a percentage S. At this particular point in time, printf would look at the sixth argument present, that is this value 0804A040, and since we have specified a percentage S, so it interprets this value as an address and tries to print the contents of that address. So in our case, this value essentially is the address of S, that is the address of S which is present here, and therefore printf will print this message corresponding to the global variable S. So what is seen on the screen would be certain junk values corresponding to the contents of the stack, like these 0, 64, this F7, FFFFs and so on, and finally corresponding to the percentage S will be the string, this is a top secret message being printed. So let's just continue and see what printf actually prints. And you look at it, and what you see is that this 0 corresponds to this particular 0 on the stack, that is corresponding to this first percentage X. 64, which is present here, corresponds to the second argument, and you note that 64 is indeed getting displayed. And similarly, in a very similar way, the other contents of the stack is also displayed, like F7, E9, 78 FB, FFFF, CF6E, and FFFF D06C. And finally, we having the string, this is a top secret message. Now, there's a better way of also doing this, the same thing, and rather it's a shorter way of doing this. That is present in the file print2a.c, where the code is exactly the same. However, we have changed the way we specify this user string. So essentially what we have done over here is that we provided the address of S, that is 0804A040, so this is as was done before, and then we command printf to take the sixth argument present on the stack. So the sixth argument in this case is corresponds to the printing of S onto the screen. If we execute this program print2a, we get exactly the same result without all of these intermediate data from the stack getting printed. So note that over here we just get the first data, that is 0804A040, and then it jumps directly to the sixth entry or the sixth argument and causes this is a top secret message to be printed on the screen. Thank you.